He transformed himself from a bullied schoolboy to world champion kickboxer, and he continues to fight prejudice by bringing different communities together in his East Belfast gym. He's Billy Murray, and he's a Belfast legend. In the 80s, Billy Murray conquered the world of kickboxing, winning professional world titles in four different weight categories. Billy!
Joe, how are you?
All right. How did you hear about kickboxing and what made you want to get into it?
I basically got started at school. I was bullied at school. It's one situation that I was beat up pretty badly, and it was just a shock to the system. And I actually played truant from school for a long time until one of the schoolmasters came out to find out why I wasn't at school. I was just that frightened to go back.
Yeah.
And my mum actually bought me a book, and it all stemmed from there. It was Beginner's Guide to Kung Fu.
And it's got you to this point.
And it's got me to this point here. It's got me to winning four world titles at four different weights, traveled the world.
I'm Billy Murray. I'm not a very good speaker, but I pack one almighty punch. As you can see, on March the 15th, when I take on Richard the Animal Hill in the Ulster Hall.
Billy is the founder of the Prokick gym in East Belfast, Ireland's number one centre for kickboxing. This is where he coaches up-and-coming champions. What's this gym meant to you, and what's Billy meant to you to get to this point? Like,
it's good to have something that you're good at. I was never good at sports or anything at school, and to have something that you know you can do and that you're good at, it's brilliant.
Hmm.
And Billy, you know, just gets you the fights and supports you and helps you in every way you can.
This gym seems to really breed success. You have a lot of success coming through.
We have 11 champions here, Joe.
Yeah.
11 from Irish.
That's unreal.
British, European, world. We've got four world champions in this gym. And we travel every other weekend we're out of here.
So do you reckon, although you've set this up and you've left a legacy for others to follow, you've paved the way, do you think you're out of the ring for good?
There's always one more fighting a dog, isn't there, really? Yeah. If I had a good cause, I would definitely. Coming to the east of the city, a lot of people think, east the city, East Belfast, and it's only Protestant. But we've got them coming from all over Ireland.
Because the cross-community thing is very, very important to you, isn't it?
Big, absolutely huge, and it's part of what we do. There's no nonsense, there's no talk of religion, there's no talk of cultures when they come in through the door in the gym. They're there to train. And we have three key watchwords that we follow: truth, discipline, and respect. And if we try and follow that code, it helps the kids coming up in the future. We got the opportunity of getting President McAleese to the gym. We had an amazing, amazing day. She
yeah.
was so keen and enthusiastic about listening to what we do with the children and what we were doing in general with the sport and about the mixed community. Kickboxing is here 30 years now. It's 30 years now, and it's a young sport.
Mm.
But what we have done in that period of time has been absolutely incredible. There is the fitness aspect, which is really important in today's society.
Mm-hmm.
We've got self-defense, which is equally as important, to instill self-confidence in people. So people come to the gym for all different reasons, not actually to jump into the ring and start beating 10 bells out of one another, because it's not like that.
It's not that easy.
It's not that easy.
As well as kickboxing, Billy's fought in the ancient Thai art of Muay Thai, one of the world's most physically demanding sports. So tell me more about the rules of Muay Thai. How does it differ from conventional kickboxing?
Conventional kickboxing is 8 kicks per round. Kicks are all above the waist. You wear shin guards and boots and groin guard. right? And you wear the long pants, and the Muay Thai you wear the shorts. There is no protection whatsoever. You can't kick, you can't knee the groin or strike the groin. It is an art form. Now you can use the elbow strike, you can come here, Joe, don't worry.
Right.
So you can go strike from here, you can hold from here, and you can knee from here to the stomach, of course, not the groin.
You can knee to the face as well.
You can pull from here, so I can pull
right down,
right from here, and strike from here, which is, it is kind of brutal, and none of our guys are actually doing that just at the moment. We start on the kickboxing and we'll work our way to the ultimate, and for me, the ultimate is the Muay Thai.
You're looking good, Nick, but you must have had some horrendous injuries from this over the years.
Certainly not.
Don't lie. Come on. Don't lie. Yeah. The hips are still yours.
The hips are...
The knees are all right.
The three hips that I've got are still yours.
Bill Murray is the new WKN Middleweight World Muay Thai Champion.
So you were fighting up into pro up until recently, right?
Yeah.
Because, I mean, well, actually, we have something for you. At the team, we'd heard it's your 50th birthday today. So we decided, you know, we wanted to mark the occasion.
Okay.
We wanted to mark the, because, you know, he's a fine-looking man for 50.
Yeah,
you
I don't want to shatter your illusions. I'm not 50 yet. I'm 50 very soon. I'm 50 very soon. You know,
you look well on it.
Well,
so,
thank you.
And so do you, too. Kickboxing served you well.
Yeah, it has. Yeah.
I just had a hard paper and I'm 21. But yeah, we just decided.
Whose idea was this?
No, we just thought on the program. You know, we'd heard you. We wanted to mark the day for you.
Right. Well, that's,
you know, read it out. It's a nice message.
Billy, happy 50th. Oh, well, nearly. From all the inside out. Very good. Please hit me.
It says please don't hit me.
No, it says please hit me.
No, it says please don't hit me.